101 PM.
Spiking numbers are being seen across much of the country.
LA's mayor considering another lockdown.
La lutte contre l'épidémie n'est donc pas terminée.
One eternity later.
Chin Chin, thank you for coming.
Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm gonna do a short video to cover the glassware that we use for each type of wine. And by the way, for those that are new to this channel, I'm Chelsea. I'm an internationally certified wine professional. In this channel, I'll be sharing with you some of the wine tips that I have gained over the years of professional wine training. If you like this video and like to see more videos like this one, do hit like and the subscribe button and join the club. Okay, so if you have been out searching for new glassware, you probably realize that there are many types of styles and shapes that you can choose from and it can be rather overwhelming. To tackle this topic, I'm gonna break down the type of wine glasses into three main categories. So in front of me, there are four wine glasses. We'll start the discussion by talking about the three types of wine glasses. So let's start with the glass on my left. The glass that is already filled with red wine. So this glass is quite a typical red wine glass. So you can see that comparing to the two other glasses, this is slightly bigger and slightly wider. So the design of the red wine glass is to make sure that there's a larger surface area. So there's more space for the oxygen to have contact with the wine in the glass. So the aeration will open up the wine and hence develop the aroma and flavors. Now the one in the middle is a white wine glass. So you can see that compared to the red wine glass, it's actually slightly smaller. So we probably call the red wine is like the larger size and this one is a medium size. It's smaller, not just in the size, it's also smaller in the width. The aroma of white wines are usually more delicate. So the design is to try to narrow down the opening so that the aroma will get captured at the top of the wine glass. Or the nice fruits or floral flavors will be gathered at the top of the opening. And also the design is smaller because it helps preserve the cooler temperature of the white wine. Because white wines are usually served at a lower temperature compared to red wine. Then the last one on the right hand side is a flute and is mainly used for sparkling and champagne. The idea is when you serve the champagne or sparkling wine, you will serve it at a higher level. So the bubble will travel up and you can see the nice effects of the bubble of a sparkling wine. So that the bubbles are burst at the top, not at the bottom. The design of the flute is so that you can enjoy the wine at the same time you can enjoy looking at the effects of the bubbles that goes along with sparkling wine or champagne. Okay, so that's the three main categories of wine glasses. So sometimes in the market, you may not just see the three types of wine glasses. You may see some other glasses like this one on my right hand side. This one looks kind of like a red wine glass, like on the left, you know, it's kind of big, but the bowl is rounder. Now this is called a burgundy glass, so it's served Pinot Noir. The idea of this glass is that the wider bowl allows more aeration, so it allows the Pinot Noir to open up, but at the same time, the design kind of closes out at the end so that the delicate aroma of the Pinot Noir gets captured inside the glass so that when you nose it, you get all the nice flavors at the top. But then the reality is more complex because out in the market, you see more than just four types of glasses. And there are many types of glasses. There's glass for fortified wine, there's glass for sweet wine, etc., etc. So you may wonder, do I need to own all types of glasses before I can start drinking? At the end, it's quite a controversial topic. So there's a renowned glassware company. I'm not gonna name the company, but it's a company that starts with an R. The company claims that the shape of the glass helps the drinker pick up the different types of aroma. The shape of the glass also helps direct the wine to the different parts of the tongue. So if it's taller glass, the wine will go straight to the back of the mouth, which is where you taste the bitterness. So that's great for red wine. So there's a research that's done in the early 20s that claimed that it doesn't matter how the glass is shaped, the most important thing is actually the wine, not the glassware. So Jancis Robinson, she's a master of wine. She's also one of the most influential wine critics and writer. She has launched her glassware collection in 2018. In her glassware collection, there are two decanters, one stemless glass and one wine glass. So I think that may speak something. To conclude, I think it's fun to have different glassware to drink different types of wines. especially when you're drinking relatively nice wines. While you enjoy the wine, you can enjoy the design of the glass as well. But I don't think the glassware should be a stress point for anyone or a reason to hinder anyone from enjoying wine. So the most important thing in a glassware is to make sure that there's a stem so that your hand is not warming up the wine. And then the glass is clean. By clean, it means that we don't use detergent to wash the wine glasses because the detergent will leave a residue in the wine glass and it may leave a strange taste to the wine. So you can just clean the wine glasses with water and dry it with a clean cloth. So eventually, if you don't already own a wine glass, you can get a universal wine glass like the wine glass in Jensis Robinson's glassware collection. And ultimately, just remember that the wine is the focus, not the wine glass. And I'll see you next time. Cheers.
With a brain full of mush, trying to sort out, what's right in front of you.